reasons, we have changed the sequence of program. May I welcome Swamiji to please release the logo for the 10th Balagokulam anniversary. The caption for this logo is Krishnarpanam, and this is something that we are going to follow for the rest of the event we have until 2020. Thank you so much, Swamiji. May I request Swamiji to please come over to the dais and address our audience and share his thoughts.
Pleasure for me to be here, and a contribution from the team of Balagokulam especially here in this area. The kids are being taken care of, and well addressed also. I would like to bring to your notice as we pass through generations, like the older generation now who are present in front of us, 60s 70s 80s, these age group people doesn't need to be informed about our culture. They just follow our culture without questioning. And there is a generation who are of 30s, 40s and 50s, or even 25, something like that. This generation, though they don't follow thoroughly because of their time restrictions, because of their hectic involvement, day-to-day activities, but still, whatever we say, they may not question, because hey, maaku endukle hey enda. They take things for granted. They don't need to question. They don't want to question. Okay, if they believe, they believe. If they don't believe also, they don't question. So the elder generation, they don't question, they follow. But the middle generation, they may follow, they may not follow, but they don't also question. But the younger generation, definitely they would like to follow, but they want to question. That is the situation that in the society now. Wherever I travel in US, every house has bunch of questions, not from elders, not from parents, only from the kids. And the problem is, the parents or elders in a family, they couldn't able to answer the kids with proper logic or reasoning, because the information that they lack. The kids are left out with many doubts. And this present generation, like these kids, 10 or 15 or 16 or below 20, they don't want to just blindly follow whatever we say without their satisfaction, their intellectual satisfaction. But that is there, the situation in US. But even in India, I could see a couple of houses where I visit. The children, they question me, Swami, why we should follow this? Why we should do this? Cow is an animal, why I should go and worship? Why we say that a cow is goddess? It is an animal. And we get milk out of it. And it is a commercial animal. So, 100 different doubts that is raised in the heads of all the small generation, upcoming generations. So, it's our responsibility to address all their doubts. If we are not ready to take up the task, then there will be a big loss of generation in coming future. And we are going to be the responsibility, we have to take that responsibility for that loss. So, to eradicate the damage, to control the loss, I look take up that responsibility, communicate things properly and address the issues for upcoming generations. Also, one more important thing that we need to notice. We may just take things for granted, saying if a generation is lost, to follow our culture, our systems, our ancient perennial traditions, what are we going to lose? We could see in Kerala what we have lost. Kerala is Devabhumi, God's own land. But now, every corner of every street, one masjid and one church. So previously, we used to have agraharam. Agraharam means it's not a colony. Every street, the beginning of the street, we used to have Vishnu Parampara temple, like Krishna temple or Rama temple, or even Mahavishnu temple. And this end of street, we used to have Shiva family temple, like Parvati temple, Shiva temple, or Subramanya, or Ganesha, or anybody. So the street is totally packed, means it is totally taken care by Narayana and Shiva. So agro hari hare chatishtete tasmat agraharaha kirtitaha. Means every street is protected by Shiva and Vishnu. But unfortunate thing in Kerala, every street is occupied by one masjid in this end of the street and church in this end of the street. So that is the loss of your culture. It's not mere damage of a culture in upcoming generation. It is a damage of a culture even on your own native land. Then all of a sudden, if you let things go like this, after 5 years, if you say Bharat Mata Ki Jai, you will be put in jail. You will be imprisoned because you are violating the secular laws. You are disturbing a democratic values. And you will be called as saffron terrorist. I am ready to be called a saffron terrorist, no problem, because I am wearing saffron cloth. But are you people are ready to? If you are not ready to be called a saffron terrorist, work now. So these 5 years or 10 years, it is a golden opportunity for us to again kick back, get back our culture, get back our system, get back our tradition, get back our ancient principles. At least you may follow it thoroughly 100% or not, at least try to get awareness about it. Why I should worship cow? If I ask you, as a small boy, as a parent, if you cannot answer and you follow, then you will be looked as a fool inside the brain of your child. He has no answer, but he is following. He has no solution, but he is following. So for which I personally thank this Balagokulam unit, especially headed by that has to spread in old city, even neighborhood of OIC's house. Then it will not be a Balagokulam, it will be a Badagokulam. Hope the day will come soon. Hope that day has to manifest right in front of eyes. Then these twin cities will roar up and gear up with a chant of Bharat. That should be the spirit of our nation. And I personally thank Amit Shah ji making our Rashtra Bhasha as a Hindi Bhasha across the states, across the region, religion, caste, creed and everything. And every individual in this country should speak Hindi. Main bahut aabhari hoon. Hamari jo Grih Mantri Amit Shah ji ne is mudda ko utha ke puri 130 crore janata ke samne Hindi bhasha ki prachar ke liye एक बड़ी भारी आयोजना किया गया, उसके लिए मैं बड़ी खुशी हूँ. एक खुशी की बात है, एक भाषा के माध्यम से 130 करोड़ लोग एक होने वाले. एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत, वन नेशन वन रूल. सो दिस हैज टू बी डन, दिस हैज टू बी ऑपरेटेड politically to a level, but at all levels the parents should also cooperate. Every parent belongs to every home. They have to make their kids well equipped with our culture, system, principles, tradition. This is the spirit to be carried out. We need to knock the door and transform and bring every kid into Balagokulam. And even Swami Dayananji has a great contribution to the society. My guru, in name of Sandhya Gurukulam. So evening, every day, we are working, and especially I have adopted 300 villages. Where every day evening we have a tuition center for 2 hours. I want to spread it to almost 5,000 to 6,000 villages now. Now we are working with 8,000 kids, Sandhya Gurukulam, especially where the place is dangerously converted. And we are entering into that bush and that den. And now I am proudly, I can declare that out of 300 Gurukulas, 225 Gurukulas, the slum areas,
remote places where it is 100% converted. And those areas, these children, they have brought transformation in their parents, and all of them together have placed a boards saying this is Hindu Swarajya Gramam. We don't allow any conversions or any religion to trespass. And even without our information, the kids who are inspired by our teachings, and kids have brought this transformation into the parents. Not the parents have transformed the kids. In Sandhya Gurukulam, the kids have transformed the parents. And you know, slum areas where they just work for daily wages, they get hardly 200 or 300 or 400. They earn money and they go drink. And the family system is not that much, you know, strong enough. And the cultural aspect in the families, you know how it would be. And religious aspect, notes further. When you just talk to them, you can see the standards of them. But still they are Hindus. But they are not useful Hindus. So make unuseful Hindus as a useful Hindus. How to do that? So Swamiji has designed this concept of Sandhya Gurukulam, where I myself personally has taken up in AP, and even Telangana we are going to take up. And we have established 300 Gurukulas, Sandhya Gurukulas. And we have around 7,000 kids. And these kids, they go and talk to their father and mother. So now many of them, the father who worked there, they have come out of alcohol system. These kids have changed. Just we teach them to do every day, go and do Pada Namaskara for your mother and father. Make sure they both should stand together and do Namaskara, not, you know, separate. They demand, the kids, early morning they get up, they demand their parents to stand together and they do Namaskara. After performing this as a ritual couple of times, the parents, they started asking, why are you doing this? They said, you are the Pratyaksha Daivam for us. Then next come the God whom you are worshipping. First, we are taught to worship you both as our Pratyaksha Daivam. Then their body got jolted with that answer. Many of them. Now for me, the Karyakartas are their parents. The people who go for daily wages, who run auto, who go for kuli, these people, they stand behind me now. They say, Swamiji, till our last breath of our life, we promise on our kids that we don't change our mother religion, Hindu Dharma. Though my target is that, but I never taught to kids. We just brought samskara in kids. One person, if you can create a good background for him, samskara, that person can bring transformation in the entire family. And if that person is very strong, and if you make that person as a corporator, he can bring good samskara in his division. And if that person is strong, and you elect him as an MLA, he can bring big transformation in his constituency. And if that person is strong, and you bring change in that person, transformation, and you elect him as an MP, you can see a big change in the division. And if that person is strong enough and you happen to elect him as your CM, then the entire state is transformed. And if that person is more stronger and you make him as a PM, that's what Sangha did, the Modi ji. Now the entire country, the nation, is in the process of transformation. That's what we look ahead. We need our leaders with strong force of our culture, strong conviction towards our tradition and principle. Not so-so, sitting on the wall, A B theek hai, O B theek hai, O nahi chalega, ye ek hi baat theek hoga bas. Wo Hindutva hi theek hai. That's what I could say. In India, a Muslim to claim that he is a nationalist, he should say, I am a Muslim Indian. Christian has to claim that I am a Christian Indian. But Hindu doesn't need to claim that I am a Hindu Indian. You say Indian or Hindu, enough. One thing is enough. You don't need to say Hindu Indian because both are synonym. So therefore, if a Hindu goes to America to proclaim, to claim that he is of that nationalist, then he has to say, I'm an American Hindu, or European Hindu, or Australian Hindu. Whereas a people who reside in India, a Hindu remains as a Hindu, he doesn't need to say that I'm a Hindu Indian. He needs to just say, I'm a Hindu, enough. So therefore, the virtue, the privilege, being a Hindu, so you don't need to claim that you are a Indian as well as a Hindu. So we are fortunate enough to be born as a Bharatiya, that too as a Hindu. I am proud to say that I am Hindu. Are you? Say, I am Hindu.
I am Hindu.
Are you declare proudly, roar proudly, gear up and talk that I am an Indian. I'm a Bharatiya as also I'm a Hindu. Because Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu, Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Oh God, let every creature on this earth be very happy. Let every plant be happy. Dev Shantihi, Prithivi Shantihi, Antarikshagum Shantihi, Disha Shantihi, Avantara Disha Shantihi, Agnishantihi, Apashantihi, Oshadaya Shantihi, Vanaspataya Shantihi, Gau Shantihi, Ajashantihi, Ashwashantihi, Purusha Shantihi, Brahma Shantihi, Shantireva Shantihi, Sama Shantiredi. What an universal prayer that we have. We don't just pray for well-being only for Christians or Muslims or Buddhists or Sikhs or atheists or anybody. We pray even well-being. We even pray for well-being of atheist brothers. And even liberals also we pray for their well-being. Even urban Naxals also we pray well-being for them. Because Buddhi, Bhagavan, usko achha, deed dimag mat do, usko sida dimag do. Taki desh achhi marg se bade. So we are all proud that this Balagokulam is doing a wonderful effort. And I request people who are watching and who can witness this, they can contribute their might to such a great work that is Balagokulam is rendering. Because as a parent, I cannot inculcate this, but the responsibility has taken by Balagokulam is a wonderful effort. Is an extempore effort. And their relentless work effort, I pray God that it has to spread, expand, and occupy the entire state of Telangana, AP, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, all these five states in South India. Every kid need to be addressed our culture. And every kid need to be, you know, replied with proper answer and reasonings. And once again, I thank this Balagokulam unit of this area for working proudly, and it's pride for the people who can claim that this relentless work should yield a best result in future. I thank you one and all for this opportunity given to me. Bharat Mata Ki!
Jai!
Bharat Mata Ki!
Jai!
Bharat Mata Ki!
Jai!
Bharat Mata Ki!
Jai!
Jai Balagokulam!
Jai!
Jai Balagokulam!
Jai!
Jai Balagokulam,
Jai
Vardhatam Abhivardhatam,
Vardhatam Abhivardhatam,
Vardhatam